for more blood. Drinking and jabbering as always.
So this is Hunval's safe haven.
Though we be a Mercian Shire today.
Hunwald, who is this stranger?
Eivor, come, sit. Bread and ale, please, alewife. I have been discussing my delicate situation with Alvgar here.
Lord.
He is a nobleman like me. One of Lincolnshire's sturdy thanes.
Hunvold's idea of sturdy is a mug of ale that won't tip over.
Alvgar has pledged his loyalty to my family, the House of the Ferocious Swan. With his influence and your might, we shall rid Lincolnshire of the ruffians who plague this land, once and for all.
We're going to see your father, Hunvold. That's all.
Indeed, Eivor. With speed and purpose, you are the axle to my wheel, the spark to my tinder.
Hunvold, your father is ill, and your enemies have every advantage under the sun. Do you have a plan, or have I come all this way to watch you drink this watery piss?
Of course, my friend. I am a man of action above all else, ready to leap and dance and fight.
Listen. I've come to escort you to your father's side. We go now, or I walk.
Ah, yes, to Lincoln! Away! But with care. The road between here and there is teeming with brigands who wish me dead.
You daft lump of lard! A single Dane will not protect you against the whole of Mercia's army.
I think you're wrong, Alvgar. And here she'll prove it.
I'm hot for a fight, Snowdog. Give me half a chance, I'll stove your heathen face right in.
Have you ever seen a blood eagle, my Saxon friends?
A what?
A blood eagle. A raw, magnificent bird I'll tear from your guts. First, I crush your ribs. Then I pull out your lungs and stretch them into wings so you can fly to your heaven as fast as possible.
Jesus fucking heathen.
You canny fox. That was incredible. Like watching a captain navigate the roiling waters of an angry river. I must void my bladder, Eivor. Then we shall set forth in search of adventures new.
You travel with a marked man at your side.
He's with me. You'll be fine.
If I had a scribe jot down all the occasions I'd warn that stupid boy, I'd be the most written about man in history.
Alvgar, the boorish nag of Lincolnshire. I told Hunvold to stay near. Where did he wander off to? Hunvold's in trouble. Are you hurt?
Unbelievable! The Battle of Bottlestone will be remembered for years to come! Alvgar, we have won our first great victory!
Hunvold, are you hurt?
Never better,
We should get to Lincoln as quickly as we can.
Yes, yes, you're right. Let's depart.
What horrible souls are hunting me?
Me, the son of a beloved elderman. Was it naive to believe my status as a nobleman held some sway over the chaerls and serfs of this shire? What cause have any to dishonor me? Look! We could sail the waters to Lincoln, sink the ships of any enemies in our way.
What were you told when the guards exiled you?
Oh, scraps of nonsense. I woke to screaming. A man grabbed me, said I was in immediate danger to my father. Ah! Horse, Pucky! Mercian soldiers then shackled me, rode me blind. And told me plainly, start anew elsewhere or face death in Lincolnshire.
What did they mean?
Oh, some nonsense about me praying for his death, hungry for his inheritance.
Speak plainly, Hunwald. I cannot help you if I don't know the full story. You hold no grudge against your father?
No, never. No, I suspect the order for my exile came from on high. Perhaps one of Burgred's final orders before he was deposed.
That would surprise me. Burgred was battling Danes until the end. He had bigger things to worry over.
Perhaps you're right. He's too contained. It must have been King Alfred, then.
King Alfred of Wessex? That's another kingdom entirely.
Yes, but Alfred has a fearful hatred of the Danes. He must have heard that I am courting one. A beauty who knows no equal.
Your Dane, Lady Love. Right.
Here's Lincoln. The city of my birth. The cauldron of my present sorrows.
Hush now! Mercian guards everywhere. Follow me.
Right behind you, Shadow. My heart beats like the drums of your dragon boat.
This town is your home?
There's Dan Collier.
Save weeping for prayers. We're not inside yet.
One day I won't have to skulk around this town with my face hidden. I will walk proudly among the people I love.
How was your father the last time you saw him?
He was quite poorly. But he has the heart of a lion and the Holy Spirit itself within him. A bout of illness would never bring him low.
Did he think highly of you?
Oh, yes, yes, indeed. The Thanes and clergy of Lincolnshire are not fond of me, but they do
not. The people of Lincoln are not welcoming to Danes.
So harsh and unwanting. Hunwald, praise God you live.
I do, my dear Reagan hair, body and soul.
Tell my father his son has returned and in fighting form. It is urgent I speak with him.
I'm sorry, Lord, but your father has been taken.
Taken? When?
Weeks ago, Lord. And well ill he was when they carried him off. I wish I could say more.
Who took the Elderman? Was it soldiers or men of God?
There were men with swords, and those of the cloth. And a healer, too. One who had oft been a guest in this house.
Galwina, one of the sisters my father put great faith in. He still has friends in Lincoln. That's a good sign.
Bishop Herivrith among them. He's kept a vigil at the town hall, looking after things in your father's absence until he returns.
Will we find trouble there, at the town hall?
You mean soldiers and the like? Aye, there have been many, many more about since your father took his leave.
Right, we'll find a quiet way in if we can. Who was that fellow?
Regan Hare? He's an old... He's an old fixture of my family's household. Loyal to the end. He helps run the place. And he's known me since I was but a little lordly. A simple fellow, but worth every pinch of his salt.
Help! 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 Gar!
Flew! Archer! Herivrith! Tell Lord Hunbeor his son has returned!
My lord, you're well.
Lord Hunward, you should have sent forewarning of your return to avoid the violence that dogs you. Lives might have been spared.
Why so surprised to see my return, Bishop? Was I rumored dead?
Oh, worse than dead. It is my reluctant duty to report the rumor that you were lost in the north, bedding a Dane on some squalid farm.
I'm not the Dane he's been plowing, and I don't own a farm.
I know you mean well, Bishop, but there's no cause to insult Swanborough's honor. You leave my lady love out of this.
Ah, your mystery Dane has a name. Sadly, the people of the Shire will hardly be comforted. Now that you have swelled your father's tolerance for pagans into a sin.
I have no patience for insults and rumor. We've come to speak with Lord Hunbeor. That's all.
Lord Hunbeor has gone, I'm afraid. He would not say where to, but I'm sure he will return shortly. Once the storm has passed.
What on earth do you mean by that? What storm?
Your father feared for his life, Hunwald. In his weakened state, he could not defend himself. Not against a Dane, certainly.
How dare you? Eivor is above reproach.
See this from my view, Hunwald. You arrive after a strange absence, with a hired Viking in tow, demanding to see your father. This does not, in my estimation, imply benign intentions.
Our coming here has nothing to do with you. This is a matter between the boy and his father.
I disagree. Everything this boy does concerns us. He's the son of our Elderman. I all but raised you, lad, bounced you on my knee, and taught you scripture. So when I tell you we don't know where your father is, nor why he left our hospice in his ailing state, it's because we don't know.
Come, Abbess.
We should leave this young lord to his scurrying thoughts. There is nothing more of use we can say to him.
Take care, my boy. Stay within these walls where you're safest. I will have a look around, see what I can learn about your father.
If my father spent time at the hospice here, the healers who work there may know something. Talk to them if you can. Find out what they know.
Must be black from the other side. Do you know where your elderman is?
I can tell you a few things, but not here in the open. Follow me.
This is far enough. Tell me what you know.
Oh, I know loads of things about our elderman. I know his favorite foods. I know when his bedclothes get changed. And I know he hates being bled with leeches. That sort of thing.
But where has he gone?
Ah, where? I have no bloody idea. Is that what you asked me?
Forget it. Are you the head sister here?
Aye. And I'm not too comforted by the sight of you wielding weapons like a war chief. We're a hospice, not a barracks. It's bad enough I've got these armored cod pieces watching me work. Now you!
No harm will come to you or those you care for. I'm only looking for your elderman.
I'd be risking my neck telling you anything. And if my head rolls, these sick and ailing folk will follow me to the grave.
Your elderman would agree, so the sooner I find him, the more quickly these prowling guards will leave your hospice.
That's a pleasant thought. Our lord was in a bad way here, and getting worse, in spite of our efforts. Then, quite against my instruction, some guards moved him out. I overheard them talking about a bathhouse. There's no working bathhouse in Lincoln. So, I gather they meant the old ruins just south of here, by the eastern walls.
Ruins just south of here. I will look there, thank you.
I pray you find him. He's in desperate need of care.
Tunnels, if you ask me. What choice do we have? At least this way, they'll leave us be.
They killed one on their own. What's to stop her from splitting our skulls?
these tunnels run deep. Was the Elderman fleeing to a hideaway beneath Lincoln?
Damn it!
I should not be seen in this area.
More Mercians traipsing across our route. Can't piss from here to Bolingbroke. Smuggling will always be difficult. I prefer it to paying tribute. Never again will we pay the mercy of Christ.
Fighting here. About what? A violent struggle between nobles and bandits. The bandits did not fare so well. A noble's cloak with the image of a swan. Looks like the Eldermen passed this way. Useful if I had a door to match it. A Saxon nobleman paid some bandits for permission to sneak through these tunnels on their way to Bolingbroke Castle. Mercian nobles made a deal with some bandits, paid them hush money to let them sneak through these caves. When the time came, the bandits ambushed the nobles, but it did not end well for the bandits. In the struggle, the Elderman's cloak was torn off, but he got away and headed east for Bolingbroke Castle. That's my best lead. Go, my eyes. They will attack on sight here. Sunan.
Prepared. Shall we begin the washing? Hey, who comes? Welcome, stranger. Are you here to pay tribute to our Lord Elderman?
This biscuit has been dry for some time, sister. How long has the Elderman been dead?
Dead is such a drastic word. I like to think of my lord as transformed.
That's not untrue.
Have you need of anything?
Why has your Elderman's death been obscured? The people of Lincolnshire deserve to know his fate, Hunwald above all.
When the guards put him in my care, I was told to keep all this a secret. Until the appointed time. When I asked who gave these orders, they struck me. I wish I could say more.
I have seen all I need to, but Hunwald will need proof.
Of course. You're welcome to search through his effects. Though I'm not sure what trinket would best serve your purpose.
I'll find something.
A box of musty clothing and a brooch with a crest. The house of the ferocious swan. This will do.
I'll return this brooch to Hunwald and Lincoln. I hope the poor boy can withstand such ill news.
I do not know what this is, and I'd rather not ask.
Yes, I thought the same. Troubling.
If they see me, this will get messy.
What news?
Your father is dead.
Wait, what?
The sigil of Hunbjorg's house. I found it near his body.
No. No, this cannot be. He was strong, a pillar of Lincolnshire. He cannot be gone.
Oh, you poor boy. I'm so, so sorry.
I am a man, Archer! Do you hear me? I am a man and I am my father's son! Do not forget it!
Keep steady, Hunwald. You are now the head of your house.
Another swan takes flight. Only I remain. Last in a line of dwindling nobles.
I'm sorry, Hunwald. I had already asked a priest to administer last rites when your father disappeared.
What?
I didn't tell you sooner because I thought by some miracle he had survived.
You lied to me!
You silly, sobbing mooncalf. Will you never grow up?
Lord, have mercy on that woman. She should have said something. It was her duty to say something.
Hunwald was the son of an elderman. Will he take his father's seat?
The title's not hereditary, but he can plead his case before a shire moot. King Ceolwulf must then ratify the decision.
Explain how this works, your shire moot.
A moot is a meeting of lords. We convene from time to time to steer the course of our shire.
It was always my intention to convene a moot, but between our troubles in Lincoln and the bandits' raids, we slipped into a pattern of convenience.
Someone in the shire wants Hunwald dead. If I have to assemble an army to make sure this meeting is not an ambush, I will.
The shire moot is a lawful, godly assembly. Hunwald will be safe, as will you be.
Apart from Hunwald, who else will stand for the Elderman's seat?
If I may be so bold, I should like to put my name forward. Under my care, this shire has found some peace this past month.
I will offer my name as well. My family has ancient ties to this land. And I am proud to say I have forged quite a friendship with the Danes to the north.
Good. My priests will spread word of the moot across the Shire and will convene in a few days' time.
Do visit my estate, Eivor. I have something for you. Something I think you'll enjoy.
I'll find the time.
Eivor, a word if you don't mind.
Is the word Christ or pagan?
Oh, I deeply regret my churlish ways when we first met. I did not treat you as my God commands, with kindness and love.
Love is a difficult feeling to command.
Yes, quite. In any case, thank you for putting this mystery to rest. I do hope we'll see you at the moot.
With Hunbjorth's death an open secret, Hunwald's enemies may strike again. I should find him before they do.
Archer went to console him. I should follow him.
Archer, where is Hunwald?
I tried to console him, but he pushed me away. I love the boy, I do. But I fear what would happen if he took his father's title. He's fragile and scattered. I saw him ride north, following the paved Roman road, to the old tall tree where he often passed time with his father, I imagine.
What devil put you up to all this deception?
I wasn't put up, Eivor. I felt compelled to carry on for the good of the Shire, until I knew the truth.
A pretty answer for an ugly lie.
See you, old friend.
That must be the tree Atcha mentioned. Hunwald may be nearby.
What a pleasant surprise. Would you drink with me?
Hunwald?
Come, sit. Stay with me a while and contemplate the view.
Collect yourself, Hunwald. There's many a man in Lincolnshire who'd pay to see your head on a pike.
Well, they can wait a moment.
Do not gorge on grief, nor give in to sadness. But let your aching love light the mead of your eyes and lead you to triumph.
That is quite lovely. My father would have liked you. He liked all those who could swing a sword and speak a verse with ease.
He had a large heart and a love for his people. I think I would have liked him too.
He and I used to wander up this way all the time. He would take me hunting, and I would catch the most wretched little things if I caught anything at all. I was a rubbish hunter. But he always said he was proud. Each and every time.
A toast. To your father, Lord Hunbeorth of Lincolnshire. He may have dwindled from this world in death, but in life he was as stalwart as this tree.
A wife's old oak. Yes.
Skull.
Skull. And then my father says, it's the right goat, but it's the wrong end. Oh, my Swanborough loves that one. She has a great sense of humour, my lady love. Father would have liked her.
Right. Your Dane lady love, she sounds lovely. Too lovely to be real.
You know what? We should visit her. We should go to Grimsby. Yes, there's no time to lose.
After you.
Nothing like drinking and riding to jostle your troubles away.
And the contents of your gut.
Now come and enjoy the splendor of my shire.
You Saxons and your tiny splendor. You have never seen mountains, have you? Or deep fjords like a giant's axe wound? Or towering falls that steam in the dead of winter? Snow sparkling like a blanket of jewels. That is splendor.
Well, if your homeland is so splendorful, why come to England at all?
You cannot grow crops on a blanket of jewels.
Very true.
I'll admit, your countryside does take the breath away.
Quite so. I love this land. And should I follow my father's footsteps, I shall do my solemn duty to protect. I know many think me foolish, inexperienced, but I would ask that they judge me by my future hopes, not my past reputation. If I am given sway over this land and show myself to be a poor leader, shame me, punish me, of course. But give me that chance. By God, I just want to have that chance.
What was that?
Birds, Eivor. Has no one told them today is a day of grief?
Shh, quiet. Stop here. Something isn't right. I'll find the trouble before it finds us.
Eivor, I am sweating head to toe. Do not leave me here.
Hush. Stay. Hide or fight, Hunwald. Now!
Father, give me strength to survive.
Your neck!
Eivor!
I'm over here!
That's twice they tried to kill you, Hunwald.
And twice failed.
We had luck, but if you're not more careful, they will succeed. Someone in Mercia wants you dead, and they'll kill anyone in the way to see it done.
Yes, including my dear Swanborough, my lady love. Come, let us hurry away.
I am serious, Hunwald. Are you hearing me?
Plain and clear. Follow me.
Hunwald, are you sure this place is safe?
The safest spot in the Shire, yes. Here I am with a chance to be Alderman, but I have yet to prove myself worthy. To you, to the Shire, to her. I can do nothing without my darling lady. You've made me realize how much I've neglected her through this fatal stupor of mine.
This I must see for myself.
Hunwald, I thought for sure you'd be dead. Why didn't you send word?
It has been far too long, my little jewel. I'm so very sorry for that.
I'm fine, my love. I wilted without you, but still I grow. And who is this?
Ah, yes. I am proud to present Eivor of the Raven Clan.
Hello, Eivor. A pleasure to meet you.
And you, Swanborough. I wasn't sure what to make of Hunwald's stories, yet here you are.
Surprised to find a Dane by his side?
Not quite. I'm surprised to find a Saxon at yours. Hunwald seems to endear himself to all sorts.
Eivor agreed to help me find my father. But I'm afraid it hasn't gone as well as I'd hoped.
What's happened?
My father is dead. Died of a cruel disease, apparently. Then shunted off to a cellar for burial.
Oh, my love, I'm sorry.
And someone in your shire wants to make sure Hunwald follows his father to the grave.
Let them try. I'll cut their throats.
A Shiremood will soon be held. Hunwald should stay here out of sight until he can attend.
What if I left it all behind, my love? Forget my father's seat. What if I stayed here with you? Just the two of us.
Hunwald, no. The Shire must be led with courage and heart. Follow in your father's footsteps and lead the Shire as he did.
Whatever strength you lack, you have in Swanborough. Heed her advice.
Yes. If anyone can lift my spirits in time for the Shire Moot, it's you, my dear.
Come inside and rest your bumbling bones, love. Be well, Eivor, and thank you.
Keep watch over that one. Men have come for him more than once.
My blade will keep him safe.
I do not doubt it.
Thank you.
Eivor, welcome to my estate, old friend.
Thane Alfgar, it's an impressive amount of land you oversee.
Quite right. I often get lost swimming to my island in this flowing sea of wheat.
You're flush with land and crops, to be sure. You're a brave man to flaunt your riches from this lonely hill.
It's not bravery, it's trust. I trust the respect I've earned keeps Saxon and Dane alike from temptation.
You said you had something to show me when we last spoke. What did you mean?
Yes, I did. Observe. This fine specimen belonged to our beloved elderman, Hunbeort, before his untimely passing. He left it here when we last hunted together. I now wish you to have it.
It is a beautiful weapon, finely crafted. Thank you.
I thought you might like it. Now, take it and come hither. I have a rousing hunt planned for the two of us. Leave aside talk of politics and shire moots. Let us enjoy the fruits of my land together.
We're hunting or fruit picking?
Both, if you like. Whatever you fancy. I'm generous with the yields of my estate, as you will see. To be plain, Eivor. If only to prevent a future tragedy.
You brought me here to hunt a bear.
Yes, and I'm so pleased you agreed to come. I suspect you know better than most that I have what it takes to lead this shire. Though its line of kings is old and ended, the people of this land still teems with life, with promise. But today, the shire languishes. It needs the guidance of new blood.
Like me.
I'm sorry?
I'm the definition of new blood. It may be I should put my name in for Elderman.
Ah, there it is, that dark sense of humor. Blunt as a hammer, eh? Like the one carried by your thunder god. I don't recall the name.
Go on.
What I mean to say is, I enjoy the company of your people. Or people like you, what little I've seen of them. And I don't care what stuffy fools like Herifriv and Hunwald say. You Danes are damn decent people. Not dense at all.
Kind of you to notice.
I remember when the Danes first arrived, not long ago. The locals were terrified, not of being raided, but of their spouses being seduced.
Are we hunting, Alfgar? Or is it your hope that I'll braid your hair?
Hunting, definitely. The bear's lair should be nearby. My old friend Grimm. How wonderful to see you here. What a pleasant surprise.
What surprise? I came as you requested.
Yes, and how is Grimsby? How are all the other Danes?
I can't speak for all Danes, but I am well, and itching for a hunt as you made plain in your message this morning.
Yes, that's right. Very good. Speaking of Danes, I'd like to introduce you to Eivor. Perhaps you know each other as one Dane to another.
It is good to meet you, Grimm.
Hey, Eivor. Did he lure you here as well with the promise of a hunt?
He...
Yes, hunting a bear. That's the point of all this. We're hunting, I promise.
There's a cave just up the hill there. Seems a likely place for a lair.
If the beast is as large as Alfgar claims, it'll take all three of us to bring it down.
I'm game. Let's get a new fur cloak, shall we? There's all manner of beasts in this forest. If we don't find the bear, we'll find something worth our supper.
I have a divine rule over the land on my estate. God shall provide. Have no worry.
This is the threshold of a beast's home. There's no doubting that. That's no bear. Wolves.
Everywhere, and not a bear in sight.
something you'll want to see here. Is that... that smoke? My God! My estate is burning like a twig!
Soon to be a sea of fire.
Eivor! You're skilled enough, and I can't tell you how to handle this, but please! My God, help me with this!
I'm in this fight with you. A clutch of puny Mercians don't frighten me.
The men who would see you burn are dead. Let's get these fires out.
Agreed.
What a mess. A sea of ashes. I thank you, Eivor, for doing what you could.
You're a man of many riches, Algar. You can rebuild.
To be sure. But I do not look forward to the toil. Sweet Lord in heaven! The bear is returned!
The Shiremut will start soon. I should return to Lincoln to see that it goes well. Archer, is everything ready?
The Shiremut will soon begin. Will you join us, Eivor? We'd be comforted by your presence.
Yes, I'm curious to see this Shiremut for myself. I will follow. When will the vote begin, Abbess?
12 able lords of Lincolnshire have already cast their stones, but they have reached a tie. 4 votes for each man. It now falls to you to break this impasse.
Me? By whose order?
You have earned the trust of our 3 candidates, it seems. Even our bishop has found a certain fondness for your hardy spirit.
It's an important vote for your people. How would you counsel my vote?
I value competent and righteous leadership, not foolish friends in high seats.
Anyone but Hunwald, you mean?
I love Hunwald as I love my own kin. But I would not put a stone in his care without fearing for the safety of both. I pray that God guides your vote today, and not the devil, as I fear.
How are you, Lord?
Have I heard aright that you have come to break us from our deadlock?
I have, Lord. Have you any advice before I vote?
Lord Hundbeor was a bold and honest man, if somewhat reckless. I see the same qualities in his son. Therefore, Hunwald is my man.
That of my own family, sisters, cousins, aunts.
King Ceolwulf's attendant, aren't you?
Aye. The king sends his love and support. Whatever happens here today shall have his full blessing.
He's learning fast. Good man.
Ferrich is such a stray on Ferrier. You meet to Lundin on the afterboot on your stool.
Get from me, Samwis!
Good evening, Elvgar.
Eivor, I hope it's not untoward of me to solicit your support, but I do need it. The vote is closer than a cat's whisker.
It is a difficult choice, Elvgar. Know that I won't make it lightly.
Good, good. But let me say unreservedly that I am the man who will lead Lincolnshire into progress and victory.
I do not doubt your convictions, Lord. Grim, good to see you again.
A hearty hello, Drengir. Seems Britain is getting quite used to the idea of Danes stalking her shores.
Where do you fall in this contest, Grim? Elfgar is a friend of yours, is he not?
He is, and a good man as well. But I cast my stone for the bishop.
The bishop? That's an odd strategy.
These Christians are easy to nudge about. So desperate they are to avoid a good fight, they'll agree to most anything a Dane says.
A vote for Hunwald will return the house of the ferocious...
Bishop.
Eivor, I must thank you for your fearless participation in our moot.
I'm surprised to hear you vouch for me, Bishop.
I surprised myself, to be honest. But I felt it would be a good test of God's faith in my judgment. Under my guidance, this Shire is crawling back from a decade of lawlessness. God knows the love that lives in my heart for the people of Lincolnshire. I pray now that he guides your hand accordingly.
Quite a gambit, Bishop. Mad enough to work, it may be.
Well then, I thank you for what it's worth. God go with you.
A vote for Hunwald will return the house of the ferocious swan to its former glory.
How fare you, Lord?
My prayers are fervent and my will is strong, Eivor. If I am Elderman, I will bring joy to this Shire.
There is more to good leadership than merrymaking. You must be strong and stern and willing to take risks.
Of course, of course. Strength and wisdom and fortitude and all that. I shall rise above the peat moss of mediocrity. Have no fear.
That is good to hear. Free men, free possible futures.
Which of these sad puppets will dance best when you call upon them?
It is not for myself I must cast the stone, but for my clan. Who will serve us best in a time of true need?
You can never be certain where you stand in another's heart. Choose only for yourself.
All free have strengths and weaknesses. Hunwald is not the most cunning or clever, but he has heart and spirit. Both go a long way in times of need. Though tinged with arrogance, Elvgar is competent and wealthy. He'd be a good elderman, but a faithful ally. Hunwald is not the most cunning or clever. Both go a long way. Lead your Shire with pride, ferocious swan.
It is decreed by this lawful Shire moot that the Elderman of Lincolnshire shall be son of our dear and departed Lord Hundbjor, Lord Hunwald of Lincolnshire.
I don't know what to say. I thank you deeply, madly, humbly. What more can I say? I don't know. I miss my father. I'd sooner see him standing here than... Well, I will do my best for each and every one of you.
Let us all raise our cups. A toast to our new Eldermen. As all well know, this Shiremute's decision is not final, but advisory. It now falls to our newly anointed King Teowulf to ratify our choice. To this end, we need not worry. Teowulf is a friend to Saxon and Dane alike, and he is sure to approve the results. Our good and noble friend, Arthelswith.
A septic rot has overtaken this shire. A sickness for which there is only one cure.
Your Grace, what is this?
Nobles of Lincolnshire, stand fast!
For the glory of the ancients, leave none alive!
Steel yourself, Wumbo.
Another battle!
How their god welcomes a new Elderman. Bastard Bishop. What's his endgame?
No!
This one's gone. Find those who still draw breath. Polish your ass, Hunwald. The Elderman's seat is yours. As your war council, I suggest you waste no time in catching this grief tosser. He won't be far.
We should first bury our dead, no?
That choice is yours to make, Elderman.
Yes. Yes, of course. We'll bury our dead, then raise a feared.
I am at a loss for words. A trusted man of the cloth. I will pray for these martyrs and tend to the remaining wounded until the last man walks free.
Be well, Archer.
And you, Eivor. May God or the gods protect you.
Ego sum habiri
a bold attack, and in broad daylight.
What news, Hunwald?
We've learned that Herivrith rode for the fort at Anicastre following the massacre. I have assembled a fyrd there. Quite a large one, in fact. They eagerly await your orders, Eivor.
You mean your orders, Elderman?
Ah, yes, that's right. My orders. Which are what, exactly?
Who can say? Ride with me to your camp and we'll find out together.
Herebrith was a friend of my father's and always so dear to me. I don't understand what possessed him.
He invoked the name of an ancient order before his men attacked. I know exactly what possessed him.
Do you?
It's not a story for now.
This will send waves of disgust through all the parishes of Mercia. Herebrith is a new and ugly stain on the bishopric.
Your Christ was an interesting man, if a little soft. But stranger still, I've met so few Christians like him.
Today has been a boon, Eivor. In spite of everything, I now know my father's spirit still burns within me. It's thanks to you I know this. When songs are sung of the day Lincolnshire was saved, your name will ripple through every stanza.
Don't be hasty, Hunwald. One verse of our song remains unsung. The din of battle beckons.
You pagans and your appetite for battle. I certainly don't share it. I worry what diabolical feast the bishop has in store.
Don't let that foxy bishop worry you. With Eivor beside us, he'll be victuals before long. How has Atja taken all this? She and Herebrith were so close.
She must feel as though the devil himself attacked her monastery. The poor lady.
We spoke briefly. Her spirits were low, but her work carried on. I think she'll be fine.
Manipulated by a man who should be God's gladdener. Here's the camp, do you see? The field will soon be ready for action.
Give them mead and let them rest. There is hard fighting ahead.
Our warsmith has arrived. The fields are ready to fight.
Chieftain Eivor, can we win this fight with the men you see assembled here?
If they fight with the bravery of double their number, we may.
And is there room in your Valhalla for a ferocious swan?
Of course. Let fly your glorious banner.
Are we ready then?
We attack now. Ready the field.
Our first task will be to breach the outer wall. Then we deal with the troops inside.
The best way to breach is with a battering ram. I should help it along.
Out!
challenge at last. Point me to the bishop. No one else need die today.
He's in the chapel there, hiding away. Scabrous coward.
Let no one leave that church without facing judgment.
Se tibi erit ipse benedictus.
Jammed. Need to get on the other side.
Of my order to a wider view, I debased myself. Clawed my way to the top of this common religion, full of common men. I should have lived as the ancients did.
That's the folly of mankind, Herifrith. We wallow in our failures, like happy pigs in a stive shit. You should have learned to enjoy it.
Eivor, is the bishop dead?
He bled too little and talked too much. Now he's gone.
I won't miss him. But Atcha will need some time to grieve.
Lincolnshire is yours to lead, Elderman. The hardest fight begins now.
The din of battle still rings in my ears. I think I now know what it means to be a leader.
Good.
I would ask a favor, if I could.
Name it.
As Elderman, my life may be a dangerous one. For a time, anyway. Would you allow my Swanborough to take refuge in your settlement? At least until I feel all danger has passed.
We'd be happy to have her.
Thank you, my sturdy Norse berserker. The mead halls of my shire will be lonely without you stomping about.
Our people are bonded now. We must look out for one another.
Blast it. I am a horror with goodbyes.
It'll do for now.
Now it seems the wind calls me back to Ramli. Best tell her the good news. Lincolnshire is a friend to us.
Wonderful news. And who is our ally there?
The boy Hunwald is the new Elderman of Lincolnshire, and he has sworn allegiance to us.
The Loud One, an Elderman? Well, should he ever wish to call for aid, he need only shout.